Hello everyone, it's me Bombay. In the last episode we built this amazing farm for our emerald needs, so in this episode we need to take care of our hunger. We will be building a barn for the animals. Enjoy the video, lads. Like the video. I actually did some off-camera work and I built this second layer to the trading hall. I just have some people here to trade me some good books like this fortune tree, which is going to help us so much, okay? And also just some iron trades. We need some EXP to get to level 30 and do some enchanting. Let's see if we can get level 30. Oh, so close. Let's try this guy. Oh, here we go, level 30. Let's go and do an enchant. I swear, if I get fortune tree on this pickaxe now, I'm gonna be pissed because I just spent so many emeralds on the book. Let's see, efficiency 4.
You're stupid.
No way. Efficiency 4 and fortune tree? Well, we just wasted emeralds. If you're actually new to Minecraft and don't know what fortune tree does, it actually works as a multiplier. So if you mine coal, for example, you can get 4 pieces of coal from 1 ore, which usually doesn't happen. And silk touch just gives you the full ore block, as shown in the video. Oh, I totally forgot. It actually works on iron now too, because it gives you like nuggets or something. Not nuggets. I don't know what it's called. It's not chicken nuggets. It's something else. It's raw iron. I think we're ready to do some building now. So first things first, look at this lawn. It's overgrown with weeds. We need to get rid of the weeds. And I think I have the best method to do that. It's called watered plants. You know, let's try that. I mean, this actually sucks really badly, okay? It's fun to see the grass just vanish, but this is so bad. I just will continue manually. We need to fill in this pothole ASAP, okay? Otherwise, the wandering trader will come, probably fall into this, and never trade with us ever again, okay? And we need those good trades. We need that sand, okay?
2 hours later.
And talking about emeralds and wandering traders, look at here. A wandering trader. Actually, glowstone and buckets of tropical fish, that's good. I'm gonna buy all the fish. Guys, if you need to know one thing about me, then it is that I love fish, okay? I love to catch fish, I love fish in aquariums, I love to eat fish too. It's like a golden trio, okay? So, I think actually I'm gonna buy out the whole shop, like the whole stock. I wanna see if it restocks or does it gain anything, because I've never ever bought out the whole shop and everything from a wandering trader. I feel like this was a waste of emeralds. It was good EXP though, and I got new items. Yeah, no particles, and it's not restocking anything, so I think we got scammed a bit, or maybe a lot. But yeah, I'm just gonna keep storing all the wandering trader items into this chest. Let's do another enchant. Efficiency 4 for a spade. I literally got fortune 3 for a spade. For what reason, Mojang? Please tell me, for what reason? Okay, I have the best idea ever, okay? I'm gonna go into the nether just before we start to build the barn, because I want a piece of netherite. This is episode 7 and I still have no netherite. This is not okay. So yeah, I'm gonna go bed mining actually. If you guys don't know what bed mining is, then just check this video out. You will see what I mean by bed mining. In the nether, the beds will actually explode if you try to use them. Into the nether we go.
Ow.
Okay, now we need to find a good spot where to tunnel to, like, I think it was level 17 or 15, and then we can start with the bed mining. But we have to make sure it's not the basalt delta, whatever this biome is. We need just a regular old nether biome and no lava lakes. Well, this has turned out into an adventure, because right now we are breaking a fortress above a lava lake. But it seems like down there there's like a regular nether biome, so that's what we're going for. I think I found the spot. Let's try it out. Here we go. Well, basically you just need a bed on the ground. You need to try to sleep in it and then make sure you have a block between you and the bed. Otherwise, you're just gonna blow up. But yeah, this is what I was talking about, lava lakes and lava overall. It is so annoying and it will slow you down by so much. So try to find a spot where there is almost no lava. So yeah, I'll see you guys once I'm done with all of the mining. Ooh, netherite. So we actually found 7 pieces of netherite, which is enough for one tool. And that tool will be a pickaxe. Okay, almost done. We need 4 scraps for our 1 ingot. Okay, so 4 gold ingots, 4 scrap means one netherite ingot, and we can use that on the pick. So I think we'll use the fortune tree pickaxe because we'll probably use this the most. So yeah, let's do that. This is gains. This is awesome. We finally have a netherite item. So this old shack needs some renovating. So let's break this down. Here we go. No shack left. I think we need to relocate the animals though if we want to build that. The materials that I'm mostly going to use are going to be just related to oak and spruce, and that's it. I'm trying to do something that I saw in one of the YouTube videos. It was way back, but I don't remember by who the video even was. But yeah, I'll probably mimic some of this stuff from my head, and if you know to who this building belongs to, then yeah, please let me know. Okay, let's add some slabs to make it look like an entrance. It looks like an entrance, I guess. Pretty cool. Relocation time. Follow me, everyone. I have a piece of wheat, and you're just all some dummy dumps. Look at them just go in. They don't even worry about what's going to happen to them in the future. As you can see, I've been a busy bee. I've actually torn like quite a bit. I have like the shape formed and everything, but I'm still thinking about the materials. I think I want to swap out a few things, but for now I'm just gonna go with the flow. These three holes over here that you see will be animal pins. These need to be switched to spruce fences because that gives a lot more depth to the build. So much better. Cannot forget to do the daily iron trades. Look at this. This is actually starting to take some shape. I'm happy with this. Okay. The roof is done, but I'm not the biggest fan of this roof, to be honest. So I'll probably switch out some of the tiles, the roof tiles, staircases and slabs with oak slabs and staircases for some more detail. And I don't know how I'm gonna make a roof above the animal pens. Okay, the back wall, what I was thinking about, I'm gonna make like a big beam into the middle. Thank God I have those slabs. I can switch these out like this. It's gonna look so nice. Now I'm just gonna add some more logs, and we need to add some windows. Now it's time to make the front look gorgeous as well. I'm gonna add some more logs. I was thinking about maybe not even like stripping the logs, the oak logs above, but I don't know. Let's see how it looks first. Yeah, it's hideous. It's really hideous. Let's strip these logs. Yeah, even this way is hideous. Let's strip them all. This looks so much better. And this over here, I'll show you something really cool. We'll add a door and we'll make a wall out of trapdoors, because this adds really, really a lot of depth to the build, and it has such a unique pattern. But yeah, obviously I'll place the door on the wrong side. I'm actually going to do the same with the animal pens. But should I use it this way or the other way? I think the other way looks better. Let's try it the other way. Okay, let's close these quickly. Oh yeah, this is so much better. We'll do all three of these like that. And the animal pens are done. We have the fences, and now we can trap the animals in there. You might be like, why do you have carpets? Why do you put them on fences? Well, if you don't have carpets on the fences, you can skip the fences, but with the carpet on them, you can skip them. So it's a nice and easy life hack. I absolutely love campfires. They just look so nice, and you can use them as detail at so many different places. And I will be using these here. This just adds so much to the build right away. Oh yes, I know what to do with the roof now. I'm gonna do the edges, so said the trims with spruce, and in the middle it will be just oak. I hope it's gonna look good. I think it's gonna look good. At least in my head it looks good right now. First peek from the side, I think it looks fancy. Yeah, we're gonna do that. I'm breaking what I built like 10 minutes ago. I'm an awful person, but I'm actually going to switch out some of these with oak variants, so it adds more detail. The barn is already looking fancy, and we haven't even added like all the details. This is going to look amazing, I already know. Time to lure in the animals now. I'll start with the sheep and then get the cows. Come on, sheep, you dummies. And every single one of you is trapped now. Thank you. Time for the cows. Ah, oh, these last guys just don't want to come in. Come on, lads. Just a few more. Okay, here we go. Oh, I can't get out of the cows. Let's see. I need a piece of fence. Okay, let's move a bit here. Yep, stuck. Oh, got him. Now we have two full pens of sheep and cows. That's food. I just came in here and the floor was done already with someone, and I'm not even mad. The stone looks mad good. Now it's time to do some interior. I think we'll add like posts somewhere in the middle, and then some shelves for chests, so we actually have some real storage as well. This is like our first smallest storage area. Amazing. We have chests and crates. What else do we need? We can put everything in these because we don't have many things, to be honest. We have just wood and some stone and that's really it. I'm gonna try something new. I'm gonna add hay balls and then a campfire on top so it looks like a pile of logs. That is so cool. Why haven't I done that before? And of course, coarse dirt with some grass and ferns. Look at this, the lanterns, the leaves, everything. It looks amazing. Hopefully this will be a massive tree. Yeah, that's definitely not what I was going for. If you guys ever want to grow, like force grow a massive tree, then just take like stone or something and make a 5-high block pillar right next to it and just bone meal a tree. It will most likely be a massive tree. And also, the hoe finally has a purpose. We can break leaves super quickly, so this is actually super good. Let's try again. Let's see if, yeah, this tree will go. This is definitely a lot better. We'll just add a fence with a lantern on the side, and it is all fancy pantsy. You have reached the end of this episode. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like down below and make sure you watch the next one, because in the next one we'll do loads of landscaping and we'll make a mythical enchanting spot. Until then, take care. Bye.